Folate is incredibly beneficial for pregnant women, alcoholics, and stress-sensitive people. But there are some buts with this vitamin. Let's sort it out today. Folate, formerly known as folacin and sometimes vitamin B9, is the generic term for folates including folic acid. They are forms of a water-soluble B vitamin. Folate occurs naturally in food, and folic acid is the synthetic form of this vitamin, which is generally used in dietary supplements and fortified foods. Folate is very important for pregnant women. First, it reduces the risk of neural tube birth defects during pregnancy, NTDs. NTDs result in malformations of the spine, spina bifida, skull and brain, anencephaly. They are the most common major congenital malformations of the central nervous system. Women are advised to get 400 micrograms folate per day for non-pregnant women, to 600 micrograms folate per day during pregnancy. Pregnant women with a history of congenital neural tube defects should take 4,000 micrograms of folic acid daily. Second, if a woman took folate supplements during pregnancy, her child's risk of autism spectrum disorder, ASD, appears to be reduced. The prospective Norwegian mother and child cohort study included 85,176 children aged 3 to 10 years. Their mothers took up to 400 micrograms per day of folate supplements 1 month before and 2 months after the start of pregnancy. This study found that children whose mothers took up a folate supplement had a 39% lower incidence of autistic disorders than those whose mothers did not take the supplements. Third, folic acid in combination with a multivitamin supplement helps minimize the risk of congenital heart defects, possibly because cardiac tissue development depends on cells that require large amounts of folate. Fourth, folate lowers homocysteine levels during pregnancy, thus reducing the risk of miscarriage. Also, high homocysteine levels in pregnant women can lead to premature birth and the birth of low and extremely low birth weight infants. Folate helps here too. And fifth, folate improves lactation and increases appetite. Thus, both mom and infant benefit greatly from folate. Daily alcohol consumption leads to a decrease in plasma folate and vitamin B12 levels, and it doesn't really matter what type of alcohol it is. Interestingly, among 78 healthy male volunteers, there was no significant difference in folate and vitamin B12 concentrations between the red wine and vodka intervention groups. People with alcohol use disorder often eat poor quality diets that contains insufficient amounts of folate. Moreover, alcohol reduces the absorption of folic acid in the gastrointestinal tract, impairs its metabolism in the liver, and increases its renal excretion. For example, in Portugal, food is not fortified with folic acid, and more than 60% of people with chronic alcoholism have low levels of folate. Folate functions as a coenzyme or co-substrate in the synthesis of nucleic acids, DNA and RNA, and metabolism of amino acids. One of the most important folate-dependent reactions is the conversion of homocysteine to methionine. Homocysteine is a type of amino acid, a chemical your body uses to make proteins. Normally, vitamins B6, B12 and folic acid break down homocysteine and change it into other substances your body needs. High levels of homocysteine have been linked to heart disease and stroke. Also, high homocysteine levels have been reported in people with serious kidney disease. Folic acid and vitamin B12 supplements lower homocysteine levels, although there is some evidence that these supplements do not decrease the risk of cardiovascular disease, they seem to protect from stroke. Several studies have shown a link between low folate levels, depression, and a poor response to antidepressants. The mechanism of the effect of folates on the brain is not completely clear. It may be due to the participation of folates in methylation reactions, the synthesis of neurotransmitters, and the metabolism of homocysteine. The effectiveness of folate in depression depends on many factors. The dose of folate, it should be higher than recommended dietary allowances. The form of folate in supplements, more effective folate in the monoglutamyl form, 5-methyl tetrahydrofolate, also known as L5-MTHF, 5-MTHF, L-methylfolate and methylfolate, as well as a balanced diet, alcohol consumption, etc. Folate is involved in the reactions required for proper cell division. Damage to these reactions triggers a process leading to megaloblastic anemia, which is characterized by large, abnormally nucleated erythrocytes. Folate can protect against parasites. Insufficient intake of folate leads to the development of anemia and a decrease in the protective functions of the gastrointestinal tract, and therefore to a greater risk of parasitosis. Conversely, parasite infestation leads to impaired absorption of folate and vitamin B12, which also results in anemia. At the Google Scholar Academy, you can find many articles on the connection between anemia, parasitosis, and low folate levels. Let me know in the comments if you are interested in parasitosis. In addition to all of the above, folate has a beneficial effect on the condition of the skin, hair, and gums. Taking folic acid by mouth seems to improve symptoms of vitiligo, white patches on the skin. Folate may slow down graying of hair when taken with pantothenic acid and para-aminobenzoic acid. Applying folic acid to the gums seems to prevent gum problems caused by phenytoin. It relieves pain in the gums and prevents ulcerative stomatitis. However, taking folic acid by mouth doesn't seem to improve symptoms of this condition. Therefore, in case of stomatitis, you should apply folate to your gums. Foods that are naturally high in folate include leafy vegetables such as spinach, broccoli, Brussels sprouts, and lettuce, asparagus and okra or ladies' fingers. Ladies' fingers sounds terrifying. Also, good sources of folate are fruits such as bananas, melons, apricots, and lemons. And also beans, yeast, mushrooms, carrots, pumpkin, cereals, buckwheat, oatmeal, meat such as beef liver and kidney, fish, egg yolk, dates, nuts, orange juice, and tomato juice. Lots of products. Keep in mind that folate, like vitamin C, is very sensitive to heat treatment, so vegetables are best eating raw, and of course you should wash them thoroughly before use. In 1998, the US Food and Drug Administration, FDA, obliged manufacturers to add folic acid to enriched breads, cereals, flours, pastas, rice, and other grain products to reduce the risk of neural tube defects. Since then, many other countries, including Canada, Costa Rica, Chile, North and South America, Iran, Jordan, and South Africa, have also established mandatory folic acid fortification programs. For example, Chile recorded a 55% reduction in the prevalence of fetal neural tube defects between 1999 and 2009. The current recommended dietary allowances RDAs for folate are measured as micrograms of dietary folate equivalents, DFEs. The Food and Nutrition Board, FNB, develops DFEs to reflect the higher bioavailability of folic acid than that of food folate. An adult needs 400 micrograms of DFE, women during pregnancy 600 micrograms, and during lactation 500 micrograms of dietary folate equivalents. Folate requirements in children are age-dependent and are presented in this table. You can find RDAs by the link in the description box. The total body content of folate is estimated to be 15 to 30 milligrams. About half of this amount is stored in the liver and the remainder in blood and body tissues. These reserves are enough for the body for only 1-2 months if the intake of folate from food stops. This explains the high rate of development of folate deficiency. A lack of folic acid causes fatigue, insomnia, indigestion, early graying of hair, and memory impairment. Prolonged folate deficiency leads to megaloblastic anemia. To avoid deficiency, the following groups of people should increase their folate intake. People who are under stress and heavy workload. Women of childbearing age. Women during pregnancy and lactation. People with malabsorptive disorders, those having celiac disease, inflammatory bowel disease, atrophic gastritis, gastric surgery, and other conditions that can also reduce folate absorption. People with alcohol use disorder. People taking large doses of vitamin C, more than 2-3 grams per day, as well as people taking estrogens, sulfonamides, phenobarbital, aspirin, and medicines for the treatment of malaria and leukemia. Taking high doses of folate supplements may mask vitamin B12 deficiencies until severe neurological disorders develop. Intakes of folic acid that exceed the body's ability to reduce it to tetrahydrofolate lead to unmetabolized folic acid in the body, which has been linked to reduced numbers and activity of the immune system cells, such as natural killer cells. Some scientists suggest that unmetabolized folic acid might be related to cognitive impairment among older adults. Now we will talk about a slightly complex topic, but I will try to explain it as simply as it possible. A very important point. Folic acid can be dangerous for people with methylene tetrahydrofolate reductase MTHFR gene polymorphism. The MTHFR gene encodes the MTHFR protein, methylene tetrahydrofolate reductase, an intracellular enzyme involved in the conversion of homocysteine to methionine in the presence of cofactors, pyridoxine, vitamin B6, cyanocobalamin, vitamin B12, and folic acid. In other words, if a person has mutation in the MTHFR genes, then his body does not properly absorb folic acid and other B vitamins, especially B12. Why is it dangerous? Folate cycle mutations are associated with various diseases. Cardiovascular diseases due to hyperhomocysteinemia, homocysteine levels more than 15 μmol per liter, pregnancy pathologies such as premature detachment of a normally located placenta, abortion, chronic intrauterine fetal hypoxia, fetal developmental defects, etc., colorectal adenoma, breast and ovarian cancer. Primary glaucoma. Glaucoma is a common eye condition where the optic nerve, which connects the eye to the brain, becomes damaged. It's usually caused by fluid building up in the front part of the eye, which increases pressure inside the eye. Mental and physical developmental delays, depression, schizophrenia, and migraines. How to identify this condition? To do a blood test for folate cycle mutations, MTHFR gene polymorphism, and a blood test for folate and vitamin B12 levels. What to do if you have an MTHFR mutation? First, consume more natural folate. Foods high in folate include beans and lentils, leafy green vegetables like rose spinach, asparagus, romaine, broccoli, avocado, bright fruits like oranges and mangoes. Second, take a bioavailable form of monofolate supplement called 5-MTHF. If you have a monozygous MTHFR mutation, you need to drink methyl complexes of folate for a long time, at least 3 times a year. Third, eliminate the deficiency of other vitamins. People with the MTHFR gene mutation are also more likely to have low levels of associated vitamins, including vitamin B6 and vitamin B12. They can be obtained from protein foods, organ meats, nuts, beans, nutritional yeast, and raw or fermented dairy products. If you decide to take supplements, I recommend paying attention to the methyl forms of vitamins B6 and B12. Fourth, improve bowel function so that the consumed vitamins and minerals are better absorbed. A balanced diet, probiotic intake, elimination of leaky gut syndrome, and inflammatory bowel disease are extremely important here. Fifth, reduce anxiety and depression. You need good quality sleep, regular physical activity, daily meditation, elimination of drugs and alcohol that interfere with methylation processes and can only worsen your health. Sixth, take medication with awareness and always weigh the risks versus benefits to your body. Check with your doctor before taking any medication. 7th, detox your body and mind. You can use methods such as intermittent fasting, bowel, liver, and gallbladder cleansing, detox bath, and using natural cosmetics and household chemicals for your home. That's it. Subscribe to my channel and you will not miss the next most interesting videos. Hit likes, it's not difficult for you, but it's nice for me. Take care of your body, mind, and folate levels. Bye.